Hey kids! Even the inside of this place looks grand too! No, I'm so bad at reading. English is such a hard language. If this was really a normal school trip, I'd be smelly by now. But why are we the only ones in this hotel? It's an uninhabited island. It can't be helped. For an uninhabited island, this hotel looks pretty well kept, and it seems electricity won't be an issue. What in the world is going on with this island? Hey girl, there's some girl playing an arcade game and she looks completely absorbed. She's the ultimate gamer, but one, then she's a trap. Who's the trap? Let's play Who's the Trap? It is a Japanese game after all. Yeah, you're right. She seems really focused on her game, but I guess I should try to talk to her. Excuse me, I'd like to introduce myself. Oh! Sorry, I must be a little too focused on my game. Are you sure about that? Let's see. Oh, right. Introductions. Got it. Nanami Chiaki. Ultimate gamer. Yep. She's got a penis. Gotta be, right? I mean, we're gonna play Where's the Trap? Ultimate gamer. Ultimate gamer, ultimate programmer, both girls. Yeah, totally. She is gaming right now. It's more like I'm the kind of person who has to gather my thoughts before I can start talking. Like, I can't talk that well unless I've already prepared everything I want to say in my head. Especially when I'm meeting new people. Well, if I get used to them, I can usually talk a little faster. She's still focused on her game, but she hasn't looked at me at all. You may be the ultimate gamer, but how can she play video games at a time like this? Are you kidding? It's always a good time for video games. I'm sleepy. Yeah, that is very me IRL right there. Oh, look at that. Look at all the clicky clickies. Clicky clicky. Arcade machine. We're at an inn in the Hot Springs district or something. Arcade machine. It's an arcade machine. Skip this dialogue. And skip this dialogue. Okay, what is this? Reception desk. I guess this is the receptionist desk, but there's nobody here. Ultimate swordsman, woman. Ultimate swords girl. State your business. Well, I just want to introduce myself. Is that all right with you? An introduction? Understood. I don't mind. I'm Hajime Hinata. Nice to meet you. Pekoyama Peko! Wow. His name's so nice, her parents named her twice. Ultimate swordswoman. Haha. Maybe she's the trap. I can't trust anyone anymore. This dignified looking woman is known as the ultimate swordswoman. It's hard to believe someone with a cute name like Pekoyama can be so skilled with a blade. Let's see how skilled she is with the staff. I've heard she's a kendo master and that most adult men don't stand a chance against her. Well, there's definitely something up with her. Her eyes are really intense. If what that rabbit said is true, we are expected to live together on this island. I don't want to live with you guys. It is necessary for men and women who live together to respect each other. Don't try anything inappropriate. I would prefer not to kill anyone. I mean, though it may seem impossible to kill someone with this, a misaimed blow can be fatal. Yeah. Well, an aimed blow can be fatal too. I'll keep that in mind. Stairs! Hope Island. I'm waiting for all these things to be renamed to like Despair and Despair Island and stuff. Even though we're stuck in this island, are we really stuck here? What else could it be? Oh well, let's finish introducing ourselves first. Look, there are two people talking over there. That's right, I'm having a hard time because it's full of poison! This really sucks. Oh wow, she's bleeding out of her nose. Speaking of which, it'd be great if you could use your mouth to suck it out. Yeah. Speaking of which, it'd be great if you could use your mouth to suck it out. I see. But I poop from there. Denied. Denied? It's nice to meet you. My name is Hajime Hinata, nice to meet you too. Why, hello there, you must be the new guy. We're all new guys, aren't we? Hanamura Teru Teru! On the streets, I'm known as the ultimate cook. But you guys could call me Shokugeki no Soma. When are we gonna have our Shokugeki? When are we gonna have our Shokugeki? Ultimate cook. Hanamura Teru Teru. I hope we all get along well. That reminds me, I have not properly introduced myself either. I'm terribly sorry to keep you waiting. Sonia Nevermind. So, this is our Celeste. Ultimate Princess. Wow. So, who are you? Sonia Nevermind. Nevermind. I'm a foreign exchange student from a small European kingdom known as Novoselic. I may cause trouble here and there, but I hope we can get along well. Same here, I hope we can get along too. Winky. White porcelain skin, sparkling blue eyes, and her hair glitters like fields of wheat. I am describing her very inappropriately. It's like she has this mysterious charm that I want to gaze at forever. To look and smell. Oh, I just want to smell her. I would crawl a mile through shards of glass just to smell her fart. Are you enchanted? Well, that probably can't be helped. She's known as the ultimate princess, which means she's actually royalty. The ultimate princess. Normally I'd be surprised to hear that, but it's not just her beauty. She's so graceful. I'm completely at ease, even though she's a real princess. This may be rude of me to say, but truthfully, I think you're disgusting. What are you happy about? In my home country, I did not have a single friend of my age whose standing in society matched my own. So to do something like this with everyone is a new experience for me. I shall extol your virtues! Oh, I can't wait to have her extol my virtues. I suddenly feel the urge to drop to one knee and propose. Hey, you three, am I being left off the menu or something? No, that's not it. Oh, Teru Teru, it's so like you to check out the restaurant first. As the ultimate chef, do you like it? I would be lying if I said I wasn't interested. And since I don't want to be a liar, then truthfully, yeah, it's I. Though I like the big city flavor in my hometown, a country atmosphere like this is also splendid. Hey, are you refined, cultured, guilty as charged? You don't seem very worried, huh? Worried? What is there to worry about? Actually, I'm really happy. Why is that? If I can get serious real quick, I have a sneaking suspicion that Miss Peko is actually a bit of a freak. Oh, she's a freak! I think she's a brick house. She's probably wearing a black thong too. Oh! Wow, this guy is, this guy's a pervert. Oh yeah. Come on. Putting that aside from now, this might actually seem unexpected to you, but I feel like Miss Sonya over there has a good chance of putting out. Oh, he is an ultimate pervert. Nice. You see, everyone knows the princesses are groomed to lack common sense. Wow, so when he was talking about poison and sucking it out. Maybe. Oh. I could tell her my loins were full of poison and ask her to suck it out. That's why he was talking about poison earlier. What are you talking about? We'll discuss this later. I better not see you try that again. Anyway, when I fantasize about stuff like this, I can't help but look forward to living on this island. When it comes to cooking and love, passion is the most important ingredient. This guy seems dangerous, but for a completely different reason. I mean, that's how I get all my ladies. by telling him that I've been poisoned. Help! A snake's bitten me! Quick, you must suck out the poison. It was a really small snake, but a very venomous one. And it bit me right here. Oh, that's it? Alright, that's it. Bum, 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 bum. I'm ready for that scene right there to also be a hentai. That exact scene. Hentai of that. Bum, 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 bum. Rocket Punch Market. Rocket Punch Market. Oh yeah, look at all this stuff that we could use to kill zombies. Holy shit, that cola! Damn! Does that mean we're in international waters? Thanks to this place, we won't need to worry about food and other necessities for a while. For a while? It's just a figure of speech, but there's no guarantee anything here is edible. What if all this stuff is poisoned? Like my penis. My penis is poisoned. You certainly are the skeptical type. Of course I am. Even this supermarket is strange. Look around. We're in a gigantic supermarket, and there's no one else here except us. Well, that can't be helped. Didn't Usami say this island is uninhabited? That's exactly my point. What happened? It's nothing. She's staring at me funny. Oh no! Gomen! Oh, why is she crying? Bullying girl, not cool, Hajime. I didn't do anything. Your name's Hajime. If that's okay with you, may I please remember your name? Of course, I don't mind you remembering, but... Tsumikimikan! From the bottom of my heart, I hope we can get along. Ultimate nurse. Well, if you've played a video game, you know you gotta take out the healers first. Ultimate nurse. Healers gotta go first. Pew pew. My mind is drawing a blank from nervousness. I went through all the trouble of preparing 5,000 different topics to discuss after introductions. That seems excessive. It's okay if you take your time and remember slowly. We'll wait as long as it takes. We'll wait for you forever if that's what it takes. I know some of you guys in chat are feeling that way about your waifus, but that's also incredibly creepy. Ah! Well, I guess I'll just ask her since I won't get anywhere. I guess I'll just ask you since I won't get anywhere asking her. So, what's her deal? If you ever get injured, you'll just need her help. And you'll need her help, so it's best if you get along with her for now. If you get wounded and don't treat it, there's a good possibility you'll get an infection and die. Help. Oh, ultimate nurse. I've been poisoned. And I need you to suck it out, please. I'm sorry for laughing so suddenly. It's just I can't help it, I'm just so happy. I can't remember the last time I made any friends. It's not that you actually want to be friends with me. I'm so sorry I said something so presumptuous. Now say something so promiscuous. I'll do anything you say, just please don't hate me. Bullying a girl, not cool. Why does this keep happening to me? I'm sorry, I'm so sorry. Doo-doo-doo. Da-da, peeking, peeking. Oh, hi, who are you? I'm Hajime Hinata. Moshi Moshi! Your attention is super low, are you feeling alright? Oh, that's right, introductions are a go-go. Miyoda! Miyoda Ibuki! Miyoda Ibuki! Miyoda Ibuki. That was cute as fuck. That she went really intense. Oh, she is ultimate musician. Alright, introductions are finished. More importantly, check out this bombastic supermarket. They got hamburger, ramen noodles, chili beans, bratwurst, pasta, ooh, melons, American cheese, Mexicans. Oh, Americans, Chinese, Mexicans, Germans, and American cheese. Americans, Chinese, Mexicans, Germans, Italians, and even people from Yubari would shop here. I'm getting hella stoked. I'm 31 flavors of stoked for all this deliciousness. And when I'm excited, I get hungry-mungry. I don't understand it myself. Why do I get hungry when I'm excited? Why do I get excited when I'm hungry? I think this one might be waifu. I mean, she likes food, and that's very important. The human body sure is a mystery. This energetic young lady is known as the ultimate musician. She used to play guitar in all girls band that was super popular with other high school girls. Apparently, their single hit After School Pyongyang Hour sold over 1 million copies. Pyongyang Hour? Pyongyang Hour is a very different song. A super popular all-girl high school band. That sounds familiar. Due to creative differences, she left the band to pursue a solo career. Creative differences. Are you interested? You could hear me. Ibuki's a musician, after all. Like Schubert, Bach, Edison, Van Gogh, Perez, and Senna, I too am an awesome musician. Was Van Gogh also a musician? You have good hearing. Wait, most of these people you mentioned weren't musicians at all. Okay, yeah. Don't sweat the details. She says she has good hearing. It's gonna come in, it's just, someone's gonna die. She's gonna hear them die. She's gonna be like a hound dog. Cola. Hey, you can pick it up. That's a big cola bottle. I bet it go flat before you even finish drinking it. I accept your challenge. Is that supposed to say 20 liters? 20L? Those are American colas. That's one American serving of cola. It looks like a vending machine, but it doesn't seem to accept money. Do I have to use some type of coin? No, you gotta swipe your little e-card. Surfboard. Skip that. What is this? Is this night vision stuff? Military goods, huh? They even carry night vision goggles. Night vision goggles! Oh yeah, we're gonna use that to sneak around at night and kill somebody. He's gonna be like, how'd they find each other in the dark? I know, they used the night vision goggles to find their person they were going to kill. Everything on this island, just like that, they're gonna use that to kill somebody. They're gonna use this to kill somebody. What's going on here? Oh, is that ultimate? Yeah, ultimate mechanic. So these things over there must. Wow, you figured that out all by yourself, huh? That's impossible. If they were damaged, I could fix them, but it looks like these planes are just for show. Just for show? The engines have been completely removed. Nothing I can do about that. Completely removed. Whoever brought us to this island must also have done that, right? The same person who's controlling that stuffed animal, Usami. But then who's doing this? And why did they bring us to this island in the first place? And how did they do it? And more I think about it, the less it makes sense. Sozo, that reminds me, you and me haven't been introduced yet, right? I like this guy. Jokokyu! Ultimate Jokokyu mechanic. Nice to meet you. Ultimate mechanic. He has a very, He reminds me of Ice Shield 21. This is expected, someone called the ultimate mechanic. Kazuichi is a savant when it comes to fixing machines. If he says it's impossible to fix this plane, it's truly beyond repair. Even so, to actually remove the engine, whoever's keeping us here must have planned this to a T. You think so too, huh? Does that seem pretty strange to you? Yeah, it's pretty strange, but I think it's an acceptable level of strange, you know? Huh? Well, think about it. It's not like we're being forced to do something dangerous or anything. That was mentioned in the safety precautions for this school trip. Remember? The school trip guidelines written in the e-handbook? we got this. I already skimmed through it, man. We good. We good to go. It looks like we're being kept safe, so why wouldn't this be like any other school trip? There's nothing dangerous on this island. Spend these peaceful and relaxing days nourishing hope. Just as Usami said earlier. It seems these rules are in place to help us do that. Are you saying you believe that this thing told us? You believe what this thing told us? She forced us to come here, you know. Don't be such a pessimist. You should look at this situation with a bit more hope, you know. Optimism is essential for people to live satisfied lives. Well, I guess it's okay if we just enjoy our vacation and see how this whole thing plays out, right? If you stare closely at that strange-looking bunny girl, she might start looking pretty cute. Okay. That is illegal in some countries. Hey, camera. Camera. I'm glad I don't have to, like... I'm glad there's no coins I need to grab. And junk. Stop right there! You value your life! Don't you come any closer. This is the ultimate fortune teller. Oh no, He's a Kai. He's a Kai from Dragon Ball Z. He's got the fusion earrings. Oh, he's only half of them. He only has one fusion earring. I said, stay back! Oh, very well. I shall accept that courage of yours. What's this guy talking about? Would you like to know my name? Wow, that voice does not fit his personality. Others may see your courage as recklessness. However, I welcome it. In honor of your courage, I shall reveal to you my name. May you never forget it as long as you live. Tanaka Gundam! Remember it well, for it is a name that will one day rule this world. Ultimate Breeder, oh. He's kidding, right? If he's actually serious, that's pretty out there. Now then, it's my turn to ask questions. Whose master are you? Eh? Which tribe did you make your pact with? Answer me. What do you mean, pact? Answer me now, though I shall cast you into a watery grave once you do. It's best if I don't answer. This guy is an anime character. He used to have a pet. A pet? No, the only male I've taken care of is a hermit crab he passed around in elementary school. A mere insect! Your magic essence caps at a lowly 5! Trash. I wonder if that changes depending on what level you're at. One second. Ugh. Gotta hide myself. While I take care of my sick, disgusting new body. Okay, back. I would like that to change based on what level you are. Trash, really? Is it wrong to call trash trash? Trash like you should not dare to speak with one as grand as me. Oh, he's a Pokemon master. I'm the great and powerful Gundam Tanaka, supreme overlord of ice-type Pokemon. Oh, come on. He definitely is an ice-type trainer. He's a dark-type trainer. Clearly, he's a dark-type. Taming evil by using myself as a bed. Truly, this is the secret art of the Tanaka Empire. The ultimate breeder. Taming evil by using himself as a bed. It's like something you see in a nature show. Ooh. I guess he totally fits the bill of Ultimate Breeder. One of my 4 dark divas of destruction, Mirage, Golden Hawk, Junpei, has this to say. We're not used to going easy on our enemies, so don't make us angry. You wouldn't like us when we're angry. This guy's great. I know he seems a little odd, but apparently he did splendidly as a member of the breeding club. Oh, that's a hentai. That's the name of a hentai breeding club. I've heard he can tame any animal and even manage to succeed at proliferating an endangered species. Rumor has it, he can speak to animals. Well, that's probably just a joke. Nope, his hamster's gonna find someone dead. Oh my god, did that hamster just eat someone else? That's the fatty, that's the ultimate fatty hamster. That's a hamster, that's Byakuya hamster. Well, he's certainly eccentric enough in that regard. I mean, there's no way a normal person would attempt to raise hamsters inside his own scarf. They have to poop. Murder time. Was that a school bell just now? Look at the monitor over there. Congratulations, everyone. It appears that everyone has finished collecting the Hulk fragments. I'm so happy. So, I prepared a present for everyone that'll make you all very happy. Please gather at the beach. May shining hope be with you all. May hope be with you, and also with you. Thinking won't solve anything. We can do that after we go to the beach. Let's go to the mall. Let's go back to the beach. Hey, it's everybody I just met. You guys were the last to arrive. What were you diddy-dallying for? Sorry, I was taking a shit. More importantly, this is our only chance to talk between ourselves before that rabbit returns. Let's talk! Now then, let me hear your initial impressions of this island. I happen to notice numerous blocked-off bridges on the central island. Oh, those are there so everyone doesn't get lost. I tried to cross one of them and that rabbit showed up and told me so. I'm telling the truth. So we don't get lost, is this island really so big? But if you look at it in depth, it's just a normal island, right? It's got a resort and everything. Well, not that I've ever been to a resort before, but... Also, there's a big ranch! There's also a large supermarket. It looks like it stocks everything from food to living amenities. Living an anemone! Anemone. The hotel is really nice too. It'd be great if we can stay there. No, you guys have to live outside like peasants. The restaurant inside the hotel was also very nice. It seemed to cater to a more plebeian taste. You fucking plebs. Can you guys listen to what I want to say too? I found something very important on this island. Poison on my penis. Very cute girls all over the place. I'm getting goosebumps. All of you are fools. I can't believe nobody has mentioned the most serious truth. The serious truth. If no one here realized it, you're all bigger fools than I thought. What did you say, you fat bastard? Don't be talking all big and shit. Small dogs shouldn't bark so loud. The most serious truth. What does he mean? What do you mean, Byakuya Togami? Did you find out something about this island? Have you all gone to the park that's across the bridge? The park is this weird bronze statue of all those creepy animals, right? We're in Hogwarts. Hey! There's an island in the Pacific Ocean, a beautiful island paradise where summer never ends. It consists of a central island surrounded by five different islands. It's also said that five holy animals symbolize each of those surrounding islands. The island's name is Jabberwock Island! And there was a sign that said Jabberwock. Here. Could this island be Jabberwock Island? Is that the name of this island? Still, there's something on my mind. In fact, according to what I've heard, Jabberwock Island is already... Never mind. Hold it right there. That's a rather incomplete story you've told us. No need to shout. I'll let you know once I obtain more information. I mean, that's not very Byakuya-y. Byakuya is much more of a bitch than this. I don't care what this island is called. Nico Nico Island or Papua Island or whatever... Doesn't change the fact that we all gotta live here, right? Living together on this tropical island sure is exciting! I'm super looking forward to it. Right on! This ain't a bad school at all. Hey, you guys? Ski? Ski? Can't say the same about the rest of you, cretins! Did I hear something? I'm still worried, but I don't feel as worried as I did earlier. Yeah, since we're in no danger or inconvenience, I feel like this won't be a problem. So when she dies, I'm gonna expect her to die at some point. And when she dies, She's gonna have photographic evidence that helps us determine who her murderer was. Hey, listen to what you guys are saying. We need to stay calm and think about this. We're all here to attend Host Peak Academy, right? But we're living on an island like this instead. No matter what, it's completely weird. Why don't you stop talking for a while? Go cool your head off or something. Eh? Plus, even if we wanted to leave, there's no way we can. There's no ship, and the planes are just for show. From what I've discovered, there's no way to contact the outside world either. In conclusion, it would be impossible to call for help. Then why don't we just swim home? There's no way we can swim that far. Show some spirit! I'm telling you, that's impossible. Then what if we cut down some trees and made a raft? You can't do that. That's the biggest of no-nos. Please recall the guidelines of this school trip. Littering is not allowed. Let us coexist with this island's bountiful nature in mutual prosperity. I want everyone to get along and live peacefully on this beautiful tropical island. What's with these rules? Who cares about that? Stop. This rabbit seems to be rather finicky about these so-called rules. Based on that, what if your actions place everyone here in danger? The word danger is a bit much. I wouldn't do something like that. I understand how you feel, but you need to calm down a little, okay? For now, as long as we don't do anything weird, it seems there is no danger. Just yell all of Nikomaro's lines. As long as we gather the hope fragments, we'll be able to get off this island soon. All we have to do, guys, is gather the shards of the sacred jewel. You gonna believe that? There's no other choice but to believe for now. That is. Anyway, Usami, what's the present you mentioned in your announcement earlier? Well, of course, I didn't forget. It's the dead head body. It's the head of your previous school teachers. We each get one. It's an Usami strap. If you squeeze the tummy, it talks. Well, that's cute as shit. I'm an itty bitty girl who's sweet like milk. You guys can clip that and use that whenever you want. You can use that as your ringtone. I'm Zeenigami. I'm an itty bitty girl who's sweet like milk. Isn't it cute? Love. What a waste of time. Man, and I got my hopes up too. I'm ashamed I even had my hopes up. Really? I think it's pretty cute. Especially how the ears look like rabbits. Well, Usami does mean rabbit, you know. Regardless, a large number of Usami straps ended up on the beach anyways. As I figured, after everyone received their straps, they tossed them on the beach. Oh my god, rude. See, even you think they're trash. Damn. Got him. Oh, you guys are so mean. It's okay, Usami. I'll have 6 straps, please. I even prepared one more present too, but now I don't want to give it to you bad kids. You had something else. Well, compared to the Usami straps, it's not that big of a deal. I prepared a motive for everybody. A motive? Oh yeah. This is gonna be good. Think you're throwing a big party or something? Correct! Is it a festival or maybe a miniature shrine? How wonderful. Miss Sonia. My loins are full of poison. I appreciate it if you can suck it out with your mouth. Girl, you can suck on my tenderloins. Just ignore him, Sonia. If you're talking about fun parties on a tropical island, maybe it should be a barbecue or something. A campfire sounds fun too. Let's find a hoop snake and kill it. Jesus, girl. Silent G. You are... Is looking for one not enough for you? It seems everyone has different ideas, but we're gonna be at the ocean. Then first... Ta-da! Oh, yeah. A swimming bag. Love. Oh, then that means... That's right, swimsuits are everyone. Well, school swimsuits, actually. I hope that's okay. Are you telling us to go swimming in a situation like this? It's not like I'm ordering you guys to go swimming or anything. If you want to go swimming, you can. Just anyone not going swimming will be killed. Yahoo! I like this girl already. I'm not a fan of her style, but I like her personality. Aw, yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Was weather this nice? There's no way I'm going to pass on swimming. I agree. Jesus, man. keep it in your loins. You're a tenderloins. I understand. Seriously, don't try to understand. How long has it been since I last swam in the sea? All right, let's go change. Those of us who were excited to go swimming went to get their swimsuits from Usami and ran straight to the hotel to change. What are you gonna do, Hajime? I understand how you feel, but I won't force you to do anything you don't want to do. But if you feel up for it, I'd be happy if you came along too. Alright. Come on, let's go swimming. Am I actually wrong? I wanna go swimming. I wanna see everyone in their swimsuits. You're not gonna swim, Hajime? How can I get you to believe me? There's no way I can believe her. How about you? I want to see you in your swimsuit. Damn. Huh? You're not going to swim? Of course I am. Why? I only swim naked. Hey! I'm not going to wear something as embarrassing as a school swimsuit. I'm going to wear nothing at all. I am so interested in swimming. I am super interested in swimming. Please, let's go swimming. I agree. No, continue. Please go swimming. Please go swimming. Speaking of which, everyone has returned. As Usami said that, I turned around and I saw a group of weird people wearing swimsuits jumping into the ocean and shouting with joy. Hell yeah! Oh my god, that guy's got a speedo. I love his speedo. I like that. He didn't just get a swimsuit. He got a speedo. The speedoest of speedos. And of course, Pervert has speedos too. You guys can go ahead and screenshot this. Make sure I'm there. Go ahead and masturbate. It's all you. All you. Oh, there she is. Punk girl's way down there. That's a lot of backstory, and a lot of plot, indeed. I am really a fan of Nekomaru's speedo. The water is so cold. It feels great. Too salty! This water is too salty. It's not going easy on me. Oh, poor Ibuki. Ibuki. Hey, I got some suntan lotion from the supermarket. Would anyone like a rub down? Please say yes, Nekomaru. Please say yes. Yeah, Nekomaru! Yeah, I want to rub oil all over Nekomaru, man. Rubbing lotion on a muscular man? Ugh. Yes. Damn, Hanamura! Damn, Hanamura just is trying to get his dick wet no matter what. Hanamura is me in Stardew Valley. I mean, like, if my Stardew Valley character joined this game, it'd be Hanamura. You seem a little too open, like you're covering too many bases by yourself. I'll make sure to slather you with lots and lots of oil. What is this feeling of intense bloodlust? Oh yes. It feels like a resort. There's no other way to describe it. Seeing the other students having all this fun? Everyone seems to be getting along with each other, so I'm very happy. I thought this would be hard until everyone got used to this, but they're all acting like ultimates. Let's keep up the pace and all do our best to peacefully enjoy this Doki Doki school trip. What's this feeling of alienation? I can't really put it into words. See, we gotta save the fan service, the really hardcore fan service of not Hina right here. We gotta save her fan service for later. Fine, I'm gonna do it, right? Then I'll do it! That's right, I'll do it! Did something happen? Hand me one of those swimsuits. Yeah, I just got stripped right here. Hey, you guys, don't forget about me. Wait for me, let me join in the fun. Oh shit, the sky grew cloudy. What's this? What's happening? These strange clouds, this doesn't look natural at all. Eh? What's going on? What did you do? It's obviously not right. It was sunny just a few minutes ago. Hey, where's Momokuma? I'm ready for Momokuma to show up. What is all this? There's no way something like this shouldn't be happening. Oh, it suddenly happened.
Ah!
Oh, yeah, there's a star to show. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? That voice is so laid back and so gleeful that it seemed out of place, but it was different than Usami's. As if an endless storm of malice could be felt raging behind that laid back voice. The moment I felt it, my body shuddered. Surprise? You were totally surprised, right? Now then, sorry to keep y'all waiting for so long. Let's leave all this worthless entertainment behind. It's time for the main attraction. You guys better hustle over to Jabberwock Park. Could it be this voice? Oh, I've got... This is very bad. I gotta do something. It's all up to me. That was an unusual occurrence. It's best if we go to Jabberwock Park, was it? Let's hurry. Hey, wait! Well, is everyone... What about everyone who's swimming? There's no time to wait for them to change. I have a bad feeling about this. I'll head over first. Shit. What the hell is going on? I'm really pissed if it's something so fucking stupid. What is this? What the hell is going on? Okay, Jabberwock Park, right? Rock and roll. I want to see everyone swimming right now. It looks like it's swallow. Wow, how come I am putting an H in swallow? I swallow a lot. I should know how to say swallow. I swallow every day, several times a day, during my meals. Malicious voice we just heard. Wait, what are you doing there, a sadistic girl? Sadistic girl, what do you think? There's just too many Mr. Krabs. Fine, I'll just step on them later. You crabs better run while you still can. Mr. Krabs. Aren't thou feeling it now, Mr. Krabs? Da-da-da. As we arrived at Jabberwock Park, Usami's shouting voice could be heard ringing throughout the park. Where are you? Where are you hiding? Hiding? Who are you talking to? Who are you? Where are you? Show yourself. There we go. Monokuma, let's turn all the hope into all the hope into despair. Why, hello there. Thank you for waiting. Long time no see, guys. I'm Monokuma. I'm the headmaster of this academy. What academy? I see no academy. Now that I have made my dashing appearance, the first thing I need to say is, this is so friggin' lame. Lame, I say. Lamer than the lamest lame sauce. Oh, lame sauce? Is that tasty? Just as I thought it was you. But how? Why is Monokuma here? Monokuma? Aw, shut up. I'm livid, you know, and I'm about ready to barf thanks to your lukewarm attitude. Just what's with this heart doki doki school trip? Crap, anyways, I'm bored. I'm so hopelessly bored. This just ain't fun at all. You better knock this off. You better knock off this farce right now. You gotta make this, you know, meet the demands of the world. Nobody wants to see high school students living calm and peaceful lives. What everyone wants to see is other people's misery and despair. What the hell is with this stuffed animal? Nothing he's saying makes any damn sense. What's going on? What is this thing? Be careful, everyone. Stay back and leave this to me. I don't know why Monokuma is here, but as long as I have this magic stick... Opening! Oh, I saw panties fly out. Hey, they're panties again! Panties. Spot the panties. There you go. No, Usami! Oh no, the magic stick! Oh no, not her magic stick! Oh no! Your two plain white rabbits are far too plain! Oh, hey! This is what happens when you defy me. I'll crunch you, I'll bite you, I'll rip you apart. This wooden stick isn't gonna shove itself in, you know? Ooh. No, that's a no-no, that's a big no-no. But I poop from there. Not right now, you don't. It's cute. What? What is this? I'm not supposed to look weird like this. Change me back to normal. My, to find your big brother's fashion sense, is Monomi a little troublemaker? Big brother, Monomi? Your current position is way too wishy-washy, so I'm changing you to my little sister, Monomi. Though it's only an external setting after all. Why do I have to be your little sister? Big sister then? You don't want to be the old- Do you want to be the older sister that got separated at birth? Well, that doesn't really feel right. Yep, you're definitely more like a little sister. So that's how it's gonna be, Monomi, from now on. If you ever disobey me, I'll never forgive you. Even the display changed to Monomi? Oh, wow. I won't let you make up your own settings. Ouch, rude. Stupid fool, do you think you can win against me? It hurts a lot when you punch me. Wise words. How about that now you've learned your lesson? What is this? Living stuffed animals fighting each other? That's like completely insane. If only I still had the magic stick, I could have totally beaten that awful Monokuma. It's your fault for leaving yourself open. Even a one second opening is life threatening on the battlefield. Hey, what's with this stupid performance? Who friggin' knows? But it's obvious something bad is happening. What is this? What's going on? She's all weird looking now. Dude, rude. She matches me, you know. There's more of them! What does this mean? What is that black and white tanuki? I'm not a tanuki, I'm a bear. I'm Monokuma. I don't understand it myself, but a new stuffed animal appeared? I mean, why is that stuffed animal even talking? Seriously, I'm not a stuffed animal. I'm Monokuma, the headmaster of Hope's Peak Academy. Monokuma? Did you say headmaster? Regardless, it appears everyone has gathered. Now then, as the headmaster, I shall make a formal declaration. From this point on, the killing school trip will now commence. Killing school trip? A school trip where everyone gets along has no stimulation at all. Oh, I cannot wait to be stimulated. Nobody wants to play a game like that. You guys agree with me, right? So, let's begin our killing school trip. Naturally, you guys are the contestants. Killing contestants? What are you saying? I will absolutely, positively not allow such bloody events. Ooh. Ka-chow. It hurts a lot when you kick me, too. Jeez, your brain sure is tiny, Monomi. How many times do I have to tell you? Pay attention this time, except in a manga, a little sister is never smarter than her big brother. Oh, poor Monomi. Now then, let's go off topic for a while. We got off topic for a while, so let's go back to the explanation of our killing school trip. What do you mean, killing school trip? Isn't it obvious? You guys are gonna kill each other. Kill each other? I see. Kill each other? What are you saying? That's impossible! Well, don't you think it's kind of lame and boring that you can't leave this island until you all get along? So I'm changing the rules. If you want to get off this island, please kill one of your friends. Then, make it through the class trial without getting caught. Class trial? That's right, the class trial is the real charm of this killing school trip. If one of you gets murdered, the surviving members must participate in the class trial. At the class trial, there will be a showdown between the blackened killer and their spotless students. During the trial, you'll present your arguments about who you think the blackened is. The outcome will be decided by popular vote, and if you arrive at the correct answer, only the blackened killer will be punished. The rest may continue their school trip. However, if you choose poorly, then the one who got away with the murder will survive and the rest of you will receive your punishment. As far as the class trial rules go, that's all there is to it. Easy. Which means if you kill someone and make it through the class trial, you get to live and leave the island. However, if you're found guilty during class trial, you will be punished. It's a familiar but simple rule, right? You keep repeating your word punish over and over, what's the deal with that? Basically, it's an execution. Execution? The pleasing punishment that follows a class trial, that's one of the perks of the killing school trip. What sort of spine-tingling punishments will we see? I can't help it. I'm already getting excited. There may even be some unique punishments, like impaling you through the head with a thingamajig claw. Ahem. Any method of killing is fine. Popular ones like the bludgeoning, stabbing, strangling, and poisoning. To shooting, beating, running over, burning, bombing, slashing, drowning, electrocution, crushing, cursing. Please choose whichever killing method you prefer. No time limit, so you can kill as you please. It's an all-you-can-murder buffet, a theme park of murder. So that's what this killing school trip is all about. I clutch my chest without realizing it. With each beat of my heart, a sharp stabbing pain coursed through my body. Somebody had stabbed me. I didn't understand what was happening to me. Don't fuck with me. That's right! Who on earth would kill somebody? I'm not ordering anyone to kill. Whether or not you kill someone is entirely up to you. But be careful, youth doesn't last forever. It'll be too late if you guys wait till you're in your 40s to start killing each other. I don't believe any of this. I don't believe any of this. I don't believe any of this. What if nobody ever gets murdered? Does that mean we'll never leave the island? Who knows? Anyway, I'd like you all to go through this killing school trip in a healthy and positive manner. Wait a minute. Why do we have to do this? Well, it's obvious there's a reason you all need to kill each other. Eh? Hold on, you've been running your mouth for quite some time now. I don't want to get violent, but if I do, I have no idea what might happen. What a fight. Do I need to beat the crap out of a black and white bear? Damn, Owari. Intense. Who would dare try to kill? I'll put a stop to it with force if necessary. If you keep saying stupid stuff, the athletes in our group are gonna lose their patience. Is that so? Well, I guess I expected this reaction. If you guys want to do things by force, then I'll have to fight back with a little force of my own. What are you gonna do? Surge, O gods who dwell between light and darkness. In accordance with our contract, I summon thee now. Come forth, mono beasts! Hell yeah, man. Ooh. Oh, that is badass. I've seen lots of strange and surprising things since I first arrived at this island. But still, the phenomenon taking place right in front of me was blatantly out of this world. Why did the statues move? Because they're robots. That's no statue, they're mono beasts! Monster! Monster Rancher! Monsters rule! I just said they're mono beasts. The strange things about genuine surprise is that when it happens, your voice won't let you express it. I was forced to accept that. The sudden appearance of a monster might be normal in anime and video games, but that's precisely why I couldn't grasp the reality of this situation. I couldn't even feel fear. All I could do was stand aghast. No, this can't be. It's just too weird. Am I having a nightmare or something? A nightmare, he says. He just admitted his brain is a total flower patch. Jeez, you guys sure are a skeptical bunch. If something doesn't fit within your narrow notions of common sense, you just deny it outright. How stupid, ignorant cavemen are better than you all. Classifying events according to their genre is a disease of the modern age. Everyone, please stay back. I will protect everyone. Even at the cost of my own life, I will protect everyone. What's this? I know, this is nausea. Your sickly sweet sense of justice makes me want to puke. Alrighty then, it's decided. You'll be my example to everyone. Oh, mon ami, your life is so short-lived. We got our execution already. I mean, come on, metal doesn't bend like that. Ripping pepperonis, mon ami. Press F to pay your respects, chat, for poor Monomi. Jeez, watch your aim. Well, poor Monomi. What was that? It's only the first stage and Monomi is already dead. Is that a demon or perhaps it's a weapon from the future? Monobeats are dreadful weapons of destruction. The sudden appearance of a monster. Even though a life-threatening monster appeared, not a single one of us tried to run away. It's not that we didn't realize it was a monster. We were just vastly out of our element. We never experienced anything like this before and had no idea how to deal with it. This reality is very lethal at this particular moment. This feeling of despair, giving an example, was totally the right call. Unlike the exuberantly laughing Momokuma, we were completely frozen, as though we'd forgotten to breathe. We just stood there, horrified. We were powerless, no different than ants washed away in a storm. Now then, I believe I've made my point. Just so we're clear, you guys can't defy me. If you don't want to put an end, if you don't want to end up as fish food, you better not disobey me. Just so you know, I don't feel mercy or sympathy, because I'm a bear after all. An excuse like, I got high off this tropical atmosphere, won't work on me at all. Because I got high. Ba-da-da-ba-ba-da-da. There, the rules for the killing school trip are written, so you better read them thoroughly. Ignorance of the rules is no excuse either. Well, that's also true for any society, really. Now then, enjoy the remainder of this liberating and harsh school trip. After he said his piece, Momokuma and his mono beast vanishing before our eyes. In truth, I was horribly tired. Everything was just so unreasonable. I didn't even care if this was the aftermath. Everyone else looked the same. We all had this tired expression on our pale faces. What just happened? I just won't believe it. That's it. That's all there is to it. It'd be one thing if we were up against a human or even an animal. What the hell can we do against a monster like that? It's impossible. Why is something impossible happening? Well, it's not really impossible. I'm Byakuya. I'm better than you bitches. Those mono beasts, or whatever they're called, are machines. Thus, Momokuma must also be the same. As long as they're machines, it means someone made them and is controlling them. Who could be responsible? Why are we put into this unexplainable situation? Guys, do you know who the responsible one is? I know one of their names. And their name is
Ikusamakuro.
It could be anyone, like
Ikusamakuro.
It's not like I believe it anyways. There's no way I'd believe something like that. More importantly, are you guys hungry? Let's eat. Yeah, I agree. No matter how confused or upset you are, I don't mind. However, remember this. I don't know who in the world is orchestrating this, but we don't need to be cautious of those machines or even of whoever's controlling them. More than anything, we must be cautious of each other. Being brought to a tropical island with complete strangers in order to kill each other to escape. That creates fear in our minds, and a desire to escape that hopeless fear is our worst enemy. We looked around at each other's faces. It was obvious from looking at their expressions. Everyone was forced to admit the truth of what he just said. We had to be honest with ourselves and admit that we also had that potential. Only a student who kills a classmate can escape this island, which means in order to escape this hopeless situation, we must sacrifice a person. However, there's a possibility that a killing may never occur, but even I'm no different. So can I truly be confident that something like that isn't going to happen? No, there's no way I can be for sure. In this nightmare of a situation, I don't have the confidence to say that outright. Once you're suspicious of something, you'll start to be suspicious of everything, even of yourself. That's why it felt so hopeless. That day became a day unlike any other, a day which held a more significant meaning. It was a special day, a very meaningful day, full of despair. That was the beginning. The killing school trip had begun, and this tropical island was the stage. Chapter 1. Time to get a proper intro. Danganronpa.
Banana. Banana. Pew.
I wonder if Monomi will come back. Is Monomi gonna come back? Is Monomi truly ripped? Hajime Hinata. Chiaki Nanami. Sonya, never mind. This is a hilarious name. Akane Owari! I like this setup a lot more than the last setup. Gundam Tanaka. Soda! Teru Teru! Oh my god, he's an alchemist. Someone's got alchemy powers. Ibuki. Peko Peko. Someone's got alchemy powers, man. Tsumiki. Oh, he's got the whole Yakuza behind him. Byakuya Togami. I still don't think that's Byakuya. Can't be. It's gotta be someone else. It's gotta be someone disguised as Byakuya. Maybe they're the ultimate disguise. Maybe they're like, ultimate disguise. The ultimate faker. Who also plays League of Legends. Surviving students, 16. But where's the 17th student? Danganronpa. Broken wand! Ripping pepperonis. Somebody's icon was male and female icons? Whose was it? Who's the trap?